What's up, guys? It's your girl back with another video. Today, you guys, we're going to be talking about growth, the importance of growth, the importance of sometimes cutting people off and isolating yourself to get better out of your life. So, you guys, I'm going to hop right into this video. Growth, it's so important, especially when you get to a certain age in the life and you want more out of life. It's so important for you to understand that you have to cut people off. Sometimes you can't hang around the same friends that you used to hang around if you want more out of your life. 10 years ago for me, I used to club. I used to be that girl, like, girl, oh my God, what am I wearing to the club this weekend? My conversations were different when I was 21 and 22 years old and 18. In that age range, I used to be that girl that, oh girl, calling my friends, the conversation that we had, girl, did you see this guy? He was so cute last night. Oh girl, what you wearing this weekend to the club when we go out, hang out? But now that I'm 32 years old, I can't talk to those same people that still stuck in that place because I have ambitions, I have goals, I have dreams, I have things that I'm trying to accomplish, and my mindset is different now. And because I have the mind of Christ now and God, I can't have those same conversations with the girls that I used to hang around. If they're still stuck in that same era and they're still stuck in that same place in their life, I have to cut them off, because you have to surround yourself with like-minded people. You have to surround yourself with people that have goals in their life, that's accomplishing things in their life. You can't hang around the same old people and expect for your mindset to shift and your mindset to change and you to reach your goals. You have to hang around people that push you, that have things going for their own life, that have goals for their own life. You have to hang around people like that. It's nothing worse than trying to have a conversation with a person that's still stuck in just having a good time in life. They don't want anything out of their life. They just trying to figure out who the next dude they're gonna talk to, what's the next club we gonna hit up. Girl, are you getting drunk this weekend? What we doing this weekend to hang out? There's nothing worse than trying to have a conversation with people like that about your goals and your aspirations and your dreams. They're gonna look at you like you stupid because their mind can't comprehend the things that you're trying to accomplish. And a lot of times, some of those people are gonna look down their nose at you like, oh, she thinks she better than me. Now, girl, you changed up on me. I didn't change up. Well, yes, I did change up. And because of that, I can't hang around and tolerate things in my life anymore that's gonna bring me drama, negativity, and just pretty much degrading the things that I'm trying to do. You're going to have to learn how to cut people off sometimes, you guys. I know it's going to be hard, and I know you've been hanging around that girl for 10 years, and you guys been best friends, but let me tell you something. If you want growth out of your life, if you want to accomplish something in your life, you have to change your surroundings. You have to change your mindset. You have to change your friends sometimes. If they're not trying to glow up and grow up like you, cut them people off. Some people are comfortable being in the positions that they're in, and that's why they don't have anything in their life, because they're still stuck in the past. They're still stuck in the 90s. They're still stuck in the 80s. And you can't hang around people like that and expect to grow. Expect for you to get that book out that you wanted to. Expect to get that TV show that you always wanted. Expecting to get that job that you always wanted. Being a manager, being your own business owner. You can't hang around people that's comfortable on government assistance and HUD and food stamps and expect for you to grow your business a certain type of way. How are you going to have people around you like that, to have a conversation with people that's on food stamps about how to plan your budgets for your business? And I'm not saying nothing wrong with government assistance, because I've been on there. I know the struggle. I've been there. I've done that. I'm not looking down my nose at anybody. But you have to want more out of your life. You can't get comfortable on food stamps and HUD, and you expect to have your own business one day, or you're expecting to write a book, and you're comfortable getting assistance from the government. I was on it before, like I stated, but I didn't want to stay in that place. I had to change. I had to cut some things out of my life because I want more for my children. You have to want more for yourself. You have to look at yourself in the mirror and say, you know what? I seen the struggle. I know the struggle. My parents struggled, and I'm not going to go down that same road again. I'm going to do better out of my life. And guess what? That's going to require you reading the book and turning off the TV sometimes, cutting people off and say, you know what, girl, I can't have this conversation with you. I love you. I really do. We've been friends for 10 years, but I can't sit on the phone and talk to you about guys and who the next dude that you're going to get and what's the outfit you're going to wear to the club anymore, because my mindset has changed, honey. It has changed. And in order for you to grow, you have to disconnect yourself from the things that do not bring you, do not help you reach your goals. You have to cut those things out of your life. Stop hanging around people that smoke weed all the time. Stop hanging around people that's just drinking all the time, clubbing all the time. Stop hanging around those type of people if you really have goals and ambition in your life and you want to get that business out and you want to get that book out and you want to get that job being the CEO at this company. Stop. You can't associate yourself with everybody and expect for you to get more out of your life. You can't do it. There's no way you can do it. And so I'm comfortable with cutting people off. Like, you're going to have to isolate yourself. You're going to have to plan your goals out. You're going to have to write some things down. And let me tell you something, especially when it comes to spirituality, God will put you in a place of isolation sometimes where he's going to get your attention, where he will take that man away from you, take that woman that's getting your focus and getting you all out of whack. Learn how to cut people off, you guys. And if that man is out there, you sitting up laying up with this man and he ain't got no goals and he's sitting in your house eating your food and not doing anything with your life, girl, you need to cut him off, especially if you want more for yourself and more for your children. Stop hanging around bums. Stop being around bums expecting to be a CEO hanging around bums. You can't do it. There's no way, no how. Birds of a feather flock together. If you hang around with hoes, guess what? You're going to be labeled as a hoe. And I hate to say it like that, but you have to change your surroundings. You have to change your mindset. And you have to want more, you guys. It's nothing worse than seeing a person in their 30s and in their 40s that don't have goals. That's just okay with being on HUD, being okay going to the clubs every weekend. When you got children out here, when you have children that has a future ahead of them and you don't want more for your children, at least do that. I know for me, I have so much that I want out of life. I want to write my writings and my blogs and my videos and potentially have my own show one day and potentially have these books and life coaching and really helping people is my goal in life. And I can't do that hanging around and doing the same old things that I used to do. You guys, you have to change. You have to grow up. Like for me, I want more for my life. I want more for my son's life. And I want my grandchildren to not have to want for anything. And because of that, I have to set goals. I have to have things planned out. I have to want more out of my life because I want my child to go to a good school. I want to have college funds for him. I know the struggle and I've seen what my parents went through, and I'm not going to continue the generational curse. I want more out of my life, and because of that, I can't hang around you. And if you're not okay with that, that's your problem. And let me tell you something, people are not always going to like you when you make changes out of your life. You're going to have haters. You're going to have people out here talking about you. Oh, she done switched up on me. She thinks she better. Let them talk. You'll be still talking while I'm going to cash my checks to the bank. You're going to be still talking when I'm publishing my third book. You're going to still be talking when I have that CEO job. I'm just saying, like, these are the things that you should want out of your life. It comes to a place in a certain time in your life where you have to grow up. You have to grow up and really grow up spiritually and have that renewed mind and that changed mind that, you know what, I can't have that same guy in my life anymore. I love you, but I'm going to have to cut you off because you are not benefiting to my life anymore. I can't have conversations with you about goals because you still have the mindset of I want to smoke weed and stay home and play the game all the time. So be okay with cutting people off, you guys. And I'm not trying to have this a long, drawn-out video, but I hope you guys enjoy this and grow up, glow up, boss up. Really set some goals for your life. Set some things aside that you want to do for you that can make your life better. Set your footprint in this world. Like, don't be comfortable where you are. Don't be comfortable on government assistance. Set your footprint. I want to be the next Maya Angelou. I want to set that kind of footprint that people will remember me by. Not remembering me by twerking at the club, tooting it and booting it, y'all. So you guys, until next time, you guys, I'm begging you, please just boss up. Do what you got to do for you. If it's not for you, for your children, for your legacy. I mean, for real, like, learn to change your mind and your friends and your surroundings and glow up, grow up, and boss up. And you guys, until next time, I hope you enjoyed this. You guys have a good day.